Ahead.
Okay, we're doing a fluorescent pour today. We're going to use a hot pink, a neon blue, a bright orange, chartreuse, and black. And they are all Sargent Art. I believe these are too, aren't they?
Yeah.
Okay. Now we have them all mixed up. It's 2 to 3 to 1. 2 parts paint, 3 parts Floetrol, 1 part water. Okay, and we're gonna fix the cups. Oh, I almost forgot. Let's add a little silicone just for fun. Three drops in each. I'm not going to put any in the black because the black is my base color. And I have a 2-foot by 1-foot board, and I'm going to do a double strainer pour. That being said, we've already got it primed with a coat of white and with a ridged coat of black on top, because I want to see if it'll just fill in the ridges or what it'll do. Okay, and back to our pour. We don't own any of the music. I just have a YouTube mix playing in the background, and it's on that My Mix thing, so I don't even know what songs are coming up. I just like to have a little bit of background noise. I don't like to mix too much once I put the silicone in. I like these colors, they're nice, they're bright. And it'll be interesting to see how a double strainer pour works. One cup. It just seems to be a whole lot of paint. Trying to just keep the flow of the paint. I'm anal. I like to keep the same colors going in the same order. Some people don't. They just go in any order they want. And good for them. go back to the first cup, maybe add a little bit more. I like to use up all the paint I have. I leave like a little bit at the bottom in case I have to, you know, make up on an edge or something. What do you think there, Walt?
That looks good.
It's kind of wild to see it in the cup. It's got like layers. Okay, you ready? Here is number one. Ready, new set.
I slack off. It's coming out way too fast.
Color. They didn't kind of muddy, but it gives it that, I don't know, 60s look. Okay, let me slide up here. Cup number two. Kind of neat sometimes to just let it flow. Now for two cups that basically have the same colors, ready, set, pull. Ooh!
Put them in a cup. Bubbles?
A little bit of bubbles. I'm going to hit them with the heat gun here in a minute. I just like to get it spread first.
I put a black strip right down the middle.
I did.
Okay.
But here, let's do it again to see what happens.
Light. Wouldn't do heavy. There you go. Yeah, I'd run that way.
Looks so cool when it's running. Especially with these bright colors.
You run it back. There you go.
Oh, I am. I was just trying to hit the edges.
Yeah. Ooh. There you go.
Now look at it stretch.
That's great. Yeah. Get the corners.
Let me get some heat down on it. And that's why you leave a little bit of extra paint in your cup. Because you never know when you might need to cover a corner. Trying to pick this up is not always easy. It's not as easy as it looks.
It's going right here.
Sometimes it just takes a little finesse. Oh, I like the big cells that are coming up. My heat gun is
over there.
Oh, good.
It's not plugged in.
I should have thought about that ahead of time. Sometimes I just don't use a brain. Look at those cells. It's even lacing down the black. Are you seeing this?
Uh-huh.
I'm so impressed. This has got to be one of our best ones yet. I like the patron who told us, you know, to do it on the rough edge. It works really well. This is a good way to pop the bubbles too, all the air bubbles that get left in the paint. oh my gosh, I really, really like this.
Call a kid on the gun.
That really looks good.
Yeah.
I love, like, right in here where you can see the big cells that came up.
Yeah.
But if you look through here, you can see all the little lacing that's happening.
Right.
That is so cool. This has got to be one of the best ones I've done yet. And with these bright colors, I want to put it under acrylic. It would look so good. Please, please, please. Can I, Daddy?
Yeah. Are we done?
Yep.